2:02 here in Mugello. Wheel spin from Marco Bezzecchi, number 72, but it's the perfect start for Raul Fernandez and his teammate Remy Gardner as well from the second row. Watch Bezzecchi here light up the rear, spinning it before the lights go out. You know what? There'd be some that would... I mean, he didn't make any movement. He had the clutch, the brakes on. He didn't move, so he won't get done for a jump start. But one rider who'll be kicking himself about where he qualifies is Cameron Bobier, who started today way back in 26th. He's up into 14th spot at the moment. He did something similar in France. He was on for a top six finish. He's definitely got something, Matt, that's for sure.
He really has.
Look at this lot here for some big points. And look at the riders in the group. Cyrene here. Also, Aldeca's in there. Bobier battling through across the line. Bobier gets eighth. What a ride from 26th on the grid. Marcel Schrotter.
Somebody's down.
It's not the race leader. Raul Fernandez is there.
It's Sam Lowes.
Sam Lowes has crashed. That's chasing it. Down Raul Fernandez.
That is head in hands. That is a complete and utter disaster. Nobody will know that more than Sam Lowes. Nobody knows it more than Gilles Bagot as well, his crew chief.
And that's hurt pride. That is not a hurt rider. He knows how crucial that crash could be. It's his third DNF of 2021.
Marco Bezzecchi's afternoon might get worse quite quickly because Joe Roberts is hunting him down at a rapid rate behind him. Last circuit, Roberts was almost half a second quicker than the Italian.
Here is that battle that Matt was talking about. Here comes Joe Roberts. As easy as that, around the outside, on the slipstream. Bezzecchi though, ooh, he thought about retaliating. But the American then moves up into fourth place. The Italtrans team look on, hoping that their man Roberts can hold on to the podium.
What about the battle for third place? Is Roberts going to cling on? Bezzecchi gets some slipstream. The gap between the winners was a hundredth of a second. It's a hundredth between Roberts, who does take third place.
But it's just come up on our screens that Joe Roberts has been demoted a place for exceeding track limits on the final lap. We saw that in Moto3 earlier. And that means that prized podium for Roberts is gone and Bezzecchi will inherit third.
So then 5.2 kilometres then to decide the outcome of this thrilling Italian Moto2 Grand Prix here in Mugello. Fernandez, he's not buckled. He's still standing firm in the face of this Gardner onslaught. They climb up towards turn two for the final time. Can he be close enough on that downhill drop through Casanova and Savelli to potentially line up a move at the lowest point of the circuit? He's still not going to buckle. Look at that though, look at the grip that Gardner had coming out of Arrabbiata turn one, down the hill into turn 10, and he's made that move. That was all about the drive and the edge grip and acceleration out of turn nine.
Great move, and the dress rehearsal was the lap before, the leg dangling from Raul Fernandez. Does he have an answer for Remy Gardner, who's on the brink here of extending his championship lead with his first win of the year?
It's going to be about the drag race to the finish line. Surely it's going to be more success in Moto2 and MotoGP for Australia.
The checkered flag is out in Moto2. Raul Fernandez is in the slipstream, but there's not enough time, is there? Oh, it was close, but Gardner takes it.
Flag, I make this the ninth closest finish in Intermediate World Championship history.
Hey guys, make sure to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any videos.